We are just one day away from the royal wedding. I can't believe it. So Prince Harry and Meghan Markle will tie the knot at Windsor Castle, of course, tomorrow. And, you know, next month is considered one of the most popular times of the year to get married. So what's hot in bridal gowns? What about bridesmaids' dresses? And what about Meghan's dress? Fashion stylist Beth Sullivan is joining us this morning. Good morning.
Thank you for being here today.
You are usually dead on, too. So I am really interested. So let's talk a little bit about, I mean, it's rumored that it's Ralph and Russo. The designer?
Yes.
What do we know about them?
Let me tell you, this is a very interesting choice. Not completely surprising, but Ralph and Russo, Australian designers, one of the only couture bridal shops in London. So the fact that they're really chosen is really not a super big surprise. It's also the same designers that designed her incredible engagement dress.
And so many people were talking about that.
Oh, yes. Very embellished. Ralph and Russo, as you can see, are just known for some stunning pieces like shown here on the 2018 Bridal Collection runway show. Extremely embellished, like I said, these gowns are elaborate. Some of them even take on an Arabic flair. And this is them themselves, Ralph and Russo, an engaged couple, and haven't even had time for their own wedding because they've been so wrapped up in hopefully getting,
they haven't been doing this for very long, too.
No.
It's only been about 11 years. You know, typically you hear that these are long, you know, established designers. So it's interesting that this may be who she goes with.
Exactly.
But what's also interesting is what you just showed us and what we typically see here in America, in the United States, is very different. And you have some beautiful examples of gowns that are very popular right now.
Right.
And I think we're still seeing some of the, the crystal, but also some of the more sleek, kind of simple looks.
Right, and I think that Meghan is going to probably do a little bit of both. You're going to have to see some embellishments, pearls, and weight because of the designers themselves. You don't want to take away from what they're known for, but she has to take it back for the royal wedding a little bit, I think. She's going to have to be a little conservative. I chose this one on Alyssa, who I think, you know, this is a beautiful piece, very elegant. It does happen to show a lot of embellishment, but again, not super over the top. You know what I mean?
And it's not. So I think it's a mix for, and is that what typical brides are kind of looking for now?
Right.
Something
now
that does give a little bit of bling?
It does. And I feel like the American bride is a lot more, I mean, I would be kicked out for having cold shoulders at the royal wedding.
At royal wedding, sure.
Which is very, very typical. I mean, pretty much almost all gowns have cold shoulders. So to find some that don't was difficult. But I will say on a side note that whatever Meghan does will have an extremely huge impact on the bridal industry altogether, probably about $1 billion a year at least. Kate Middleton's dress, her Alexander McQueen, was very taken back. But the lace and the long sleeves hit really big.
This does not surprise me.
No.
Remember the coat that Meghan Markle was wearing?
Incredible.
When she announced their engagement, and that went in a day,
absolutely.
I think. So if we look at some of the gowns then here that are very popular, for those brides at home who maybe are thinking about getting engaged, there are a lot of different options.
Yes, and these are all from One Fine Day Bridal right here in San Marco. I love this shop, and they really have some beautiful designers. I love this one on Laura right here. The 3D pops, again, embellished embroidery. Other things you're going to see from Ralph and Russo, if that is who she goes with, we're saying if. So this beautiful gown, also A-lined. You know, I have to say the A-line is, and on Aurora as well, we kind of are showing the A-line because that's probably what a princess will wear. I'd love to see her in something more form-fitting. However, I'm not sure that she will.
I think it's conservative, certainly. And
yes.
I love the veil here as well.
Yes, she absolutely is going to have to wear more than likely a long veil that's kind of going with tradition. Whether or not the veil is popular, the same thing with the tiara. It's not a written rule, but it is 100% something that is kind of following tradition. And I feel like she will wear a tiara and she will wear a long veil, most likely.
Well, I think that's what we typically see too. I mean, it is a princess after all.
Right.
And then when it comes to local trends for bridesmaid, I guess it depends on the time of year.
It sure does.
And whether or not it's a formal wedding or not.
Exactly. And we know that Meghan is not going to have bridesmaids. They do have attendants at the royal wedding. Typically they're children or younger kids. But, you know, an American wedding, you're going to have a bridesmaid. And some of the most beautiful trends that we were thinking of here that it would maybe differ is, number one, we love the navy. We think that's very classic. We're going to see a lot of women in navy, definitely long dresses, closed-toed shoes, but not cold shoulders, again. And then, of course, this season for floral prints, these two are both from Bella Bridesmaids. These beautiful pieces are absolutely right on trend in American trends, and I think that these would also be with the aside of the
cold
shoulders.
And here in Florida, with as warm as it gets, particularly during the summer, you don't want something that you're going to be sweating in, particularly for the pictures after.
That's
we want
right.
to give a shout out very quickly, Beth, also because some of the hairstyles are beautiful, including your own as well.
Yes, thank you so much from Astor Hair Studio. They were really talking a lot about, this morning, the girls all met there. We talked a lot about what they think that Meghan Markle's hair will look like. There was a lot of controversy of what we think. You know, some girls are like, no, wavy, beachy hair. With just the tiara.
Up, down, just to know.
Right. It really is going to be interesting. If I had to guess, I would say half up, half down in the tiara.
Right. Well, we'll find out.
We'll see.
Beth Sullivan here. Thank you, ladies, for being here. You look beautiful.
Gorgeous.
We appreciate it. And, of course, don't forget our royal wedding coverage begins bright and early tomorrow morning. I'll be here along with Bruce, Melanie, Nikki, and Vic, and the rest of the weekend crew. We'll bring you live coverage of the arrivals of the royal family.
Woo-hoo.
And, of course, the bride and the groom. It all kicks off right here on News 4 Jax at 5 a.m. The wedding itself begins at 7 o'clock our time.